Camden residents are returning to their homes to assess the damage caused by Thursday's flooding. Warnings are still in place for the Hawkesbury after communities were cut off and bridges closed.
After days of rain clouds choking our skies, finally some sunshine. A welcome change in the weather, but water still lapping at the gutters of properties in Richmond this morning. Widespread flood warnings remaining for the swollen Hawkesbury and Nepean rivers.
The trauma of any one of these events impacting your property and your life in such a huge way is massive. To go through that twice in a few weeks is terrible for people.
In the southwest, the pressure hoses were out. Instead of reopening today after the damage caused by last month's flood, Camden Petroleum was cleaning up, while businesses along the Hawkesbury are also feeling it. Simon McQuillan said to lose $300,000 for a now wiped out Easter period.
We've just got to push bookings ahead to other times, cancel bookings. It's usually a very busy time of the year for us.
The river simply too unpredictable to rent out his houseboats.
This sort of thing can happen. It's just annoying when it does happen, but you just got to kind of pick yourself up and keep going.
Upstream at Windsor, the town's flood-proof bridge closed yet again today. The North Richmond Bridge swallowed, cutting off the community, the flood fatigue becoming all too real for this region.
This is just one pile of rubbish left behind from last month's floods here along the Hawkesbury. Many homes and businesses had only just finished rebuilding after the deluge last year, and now they've had to start all over again.
We won't know exactly what damage we've got until obviously the water recedes fully. The people I'd be concerned about most are turf and vegetable farmers along the river.
Back in the city, our iconic harbour was anything but postcard worthy today. The remnants of murky floodwaters also polluting our beaches. 128 swimming spots considered unsafe to swim. At Randwick, drenched turf after relentless rain was given a turbo dry-off so the races could go ahead. Only 4 months into the year and already back-to-back floods for so many communities. Their resilience wearing thin with more rain forecast next week. Hayley Francis, Nine News.